Thanks, guys. I'm here at the Call It A Night studio with host Julie Stewart-Binks, who just arrived on set. Julie, how are you feeling about tonight's show?
Feeling really good. Monologue jokes are going to hit. We got great interview questions. Graphics are strong. Pucks on net.
I would be remiss not to ask you this, but sources tell me that tonight's show will be canceled once it wraps up. Why are you looking at me like that? Does something smell bad? What's your issue? Okay. Guys, back to you in the studio.
To Call It A Night, the sports show with a bit of an edge. I'm your host, Julie Stewart-Binks, and on this wonderful Thursday, we're so excited to have our first musical guest on the show, Brian Rosenworcel, drummer for the band Guster. Brian, yes, congratulations. Thank you for being here with us. Finally, you get a mic today. You said drummers don't usually get to speak.
Yeah. Usually I play drums, and the microphones are on the drums, and if I had to say something, I'd have to like go to the snare mic and be like, I'm here too.
Yeah. Well, they can hear you, and now we can talk.
Tonight I can just talk about
everything.
You want to know what I think about sports, which is amazing.
I know, and we're going to get into all of that later on. Brian's not only a wildly talented drummer, he's also a massive sports fan, and we're going to dive into a few of his top five sports lists later in the show, and he's also going to teach me all secrets of the bongo drums. But first, let's dive into tonight's headlines. The Washington Nationals beat the St. Louis Cardinals to earn a trip to their very first World Series in an unexpected four-game sweep. And like many first times, the player said it happened faster than expected, but felt amazing. I don't know if it feels amazing the first time, but the Cards were shut down faster than a Daryl Morey tweet.
Oh, wow, that's good. Topical.
Yeah, it is. Washington quarterback Alex Smith said he needed 17 surgeries to repair a gruesome leg injury he suffered in 2018. Even after the 17 surgeries, he somehow still hadn't hit his deductible.
That's good.
Yeah, America. America healthcare joke.
Go to Canada for
our
surgeries.
Yeah, yeah, that's what you should do. Also, two fewer surgeries than Kris Jenner. Side note. After his controversial statements regarding the NBA and China saga, LeBron James said to the media, I won't talk about it again, which he tweeted in perfect Mandarin. In response to the star's comments, hundreds of protesters burned LeBron's jersey, which now happens so often. Nike has designed a special fireproof edition. Yeah, lots of people hate LeBron, sadly. I mean, well, now even more so, and for good reason. All right, moving on. Manager Joe Maddon has agreed to terms with the Los Angeles Angels. While details of the contract haven't been made public, sources say the famously relaxed Maddon has agreed to be paid in Grateful Dead bootlegs and weed. Allegedly weed. Hundreds of birds launched themselves into the side of the NASCAR Hall of Fame on Tuesday night, killing themselves. The building's window washers are calling it the greatest compliment they've ever received.
If you had a studio audience, I wouldn't feel so much pressure to laugh audibly. I'm laughing on the inside. I feel like I should laugh out loud every time.
I know, you feel bad. You're like, I want to help you. I want to throw you, you know, a life raft. And we keep on trucking here. ALCS Game 4 was rained out Wednesday night as inclement weather moved in over the city, including a strong breeze coming from the Yankee bat striking out. Now, the Yankees are a confident bunch, though. Gary Sanchez says he's already expecting a strikeout in the World Series. The Yankees left a ton of men on base during their series with Houston. In fact, they've stranded more men than the Kardashians. Just keep hitting the Yankees. Lots. Maybe not Thursday night. We'll have to see.
Let's name them all.
I wouldn't even know. Canada's men's soccer team produced a shocking win over the United States Tuesday night. Captain Scott Arfield credited the win to preparation, execution, and denim uniforms. Love that Canadian tuxedo. After the win, the team celebrated with champagne, high fives, and universal healthcare. There we go. Yeah, I was gonna bring it back, yep. That's the headlines, baby, and print it. We're gonna take our first time out on the program, but don't go anywhere. Still lots of fun to come, including a little banging the bongos with Brian. Watch out, Lady Gaga and Bradley Cooper. Here we come! Welcome back to Call Tonight. I'm JSB. We've got Brian Rosenworcel, the drummer from Guster, here with us today. You have the honor of being our first musical guest. We're playing some Guster right now.
Yes, you are.
Yeah, I'm sure you haven't heard this before. We know you're also a massive sports fan. That's sort of how we became friends on Instagram. And you slid into my DMs. And you guys are a Boston band, but you particularly are a New York sports fan. How do you deal with that?
Yeah, well, I grew up in Connecticut, and Connecticut either goes to Boston and the New England Patriots, or you go to New York. And my parents are from Brooklyn, and so it was the Mets, the Giants, and the Knicks for me growing up.
Okay.
And I never liked a Boston sports team until the Red Sox came back from 3-0 to win and break the curse. What year was that? 2004?
Yeah.
2004.
That's when you became a you went to the other side then, I guess.
Yeah, because the Yankees are just so abhorrent, and I wanted them to lose. when you're a Mets fan, it's like Mets or Yankees. You can like the Giants and the Jets, but Mets or Yankees, what the?
That's why you liked all those Yankees jokes there.
Oh yeah, it was fabulous. Do more.
Now you just mentioned Giants and Jets. You're an NFL fan too, but you have sort of an interest that's different than what people would think. Tell me about some of your favorite players in the NFL that have played.
Okay, well, I made a list. I made a top five list
because
I wanted to be prepared for Call It A Night. But like watching football now is different than it used to be.
Right.
So like coming in at number five, Andrew Luck, because he was really brave and he left because they should all retire. Sorry, is it getting heavy and dark right now?
Oh, no, let's go.
Okay.
Let's go, even darker, baby.
Okay, number four, Chris Borland. You don't know who that is, but he played 1 year for the 49ers, and then he retired because he had like 3 concussions, and was like, I'm not gonna mess up my brain.
Right.
And then he started After the Impact, which is like this thing that helps players transition to their lives after the game and deal with their injuries and everything. So you're starting to sense that my top five list is like all people who retired early.
Yeah, who actually don't play football. Oh, but that they had the courage to step away from the game.
Yeah, right? Well, my number three is David Tyree, and I like him because he caught a football against his helmet.
That's impressive. Not retiring story, but
no. But you know that was his final NFL catch.
Wow.
Never made another catch. Never caught another football after that.
Good one to have as your final one then.
Do you also know that he said he would give that catch back if he could just end gay marriage? Terrible, right?
Said that?
Yeah. So he's not really one of my favorites.
Well, yeah, okay. Well, that bum can go. Let's go down to number two. You got a tie here.
I had a tie. My two Detroit Lions who retired at the peak of their careers, Barry Sanders and Calvin Johnson. I don't think they were worried about, like, head injuries. I think they were just tired of being on the Lions.
Yeah.
Like, Barry Sanders was about to become the all-time leading rusher of, like, one more season, and he was like, no.
Like, I can't do this anymore.
Do you know that I looked in the audience in the 90s. We were playing in Ann Arbor at a place called Rick's. It was, like, about the size of this room. And Barry Sanders was sitting at the bar.
No way.
I thought I was imagining it. And I still think maybe I was imagining it. I'm like, what is he doing at a Guster show with, like, 40 people?
How did that make you feel?
I think he was looking to meet somebody.
Oh, okay. So you guys were sort of in the background.
I don't think he was there to take in any Guster songs.
No, you never know. You never know.
You never know.
All right, number one, you've talked about this guy for a while.
Okay, Rosie Grier. I don't know. When I was a kid, we'd see this movie called Free to Be You and Me in school, and there was this, it's kind of like this hippy-dippy thing where, you know, people should be sensitive to each other, and there was a song called It's All Right to Cry, and it was this big, fat African-American athlete named Rosie Grier playing guitar and singing It's All Right to Cry. And I was like, what is this? And at the end he goes, it's all right to cry, little boy. I know some big boys who cry too. And I was like, who is this man that is speaking to me? Because I cried all the time. And so he's this amazing human being who like was in the fearsome foursome, was a linebacker, was incredible. And then he made a book called Needlepoint for Men. And he's saying, it's all right to cry. And he like showed his sensitive side. And then he was a bodyguard for RFK.
Wow.
And actually like was the night RFK was assassinated, he like wrestled the gun away from the assassinator.
Wow, an incredible
I think he's just assassin.
Person.
Yeah, and then there's more. And then he became a hardcore Republican.
Yeah, okay. Everyone on the other side.
But mainly because he like had like strong feelings about school prayer and stuff. And he spoke at the Republican National Convention when Ronald Reagan was the nominee. And then the last year at age 87, he decided to run for governor of California. Hmm.
You're like a Wikipedia for Rosenworcel.
I love Rosenworcel.
But what I do like what you've mentioned with him is the idea that you can be a tough guy, but you can also be sensitive, sympathetic, have another side to you, which we don't see a lot in sports. We see sort of like a toxic masculinity a lot of the time. And that's not necessarily the best message for, you know, you said you're a young boy growing up, seeing that, seeing Rosie Grier would help you sort of be in touch and be okay with your feelings.
Yeah, it really made an impression on me. Mm-hmm. You know, that toxic side of it never really appealed to me. Like, I watched the Hartford Whalers, but I'd be at the games and I'd be like, why are they fighting? I wish they wouldn't fight. I just want to see them play hockey. Yeah. But all the guys around me would be like, ah!
Yeah, that... can you
but why do again? They? Why do they let him fight?
I don't know. It's just like a part of the game that it really doesn't make a whole lot of sense. I like fighting because I'm an asshole, but I like that kind of aggression. But this is about you. Let's get into one more thing that we have time for right now. We have a lot of sports broadcasters sit on this couch. You have your top five that you hate.
My top five.
Let's roll it out.
Least favorite
yes.
TV sports
number
journalist.
Five coming at number five is
Stephen A. Smith. I just can't do the Stephen A. Smith. I can't do it.
It's a lot of yelling.
Yeah, a lot of yelling. It's just I can't watch it. Sorry.
Number four.
We have a tie here. Bill Walton and Bill Simmons, because they're both named Bill, and because I really had six people on my list.
I just hate guys named Bill.
Bill Walton is so self-righteous calling a basketball game. I just can't listen to him. And Bill Simmons, I used to love reading him, but that doesn't mean he's good on TV. He kind of sounds like mousy.
What about his podcast?
I didn't like it. His voice was kind of mousy.
Yeah, I think that's his thing, right?
I mean, my voice is mousier. It's fine.
No, not as mousy as his. All right, let's get to number three on this list.
Oh, Kenny Smith. I mean, I can handle, I love Shaq, I love the guy with the bow tie, I love Charles Barkley. I can't do the Kenny Smith, he doesn't add anything. You're not adding anything.
Yeah, I feel like there's a lot of guys like that on TV these days. Number two, we've got Skip.
Skip Bayless, I mean, yeah. Oh, my goodness. I mean, I don't have to even talk about why.
Now look at that photo.
I know that you're thinking my number one is going to be Joe Buck, but it's not.
Ooh, suspense. And the number one least favorite sports broadcaster on Brian's list is...
Jim Gray. Oh, wow. Right? You guys don't even know who he is because he's from my generation. But he would just make everyone uncomfortable. It was just like at the end of like the NBA finals, he'd be there sweating with the microphone and just no one liked him. And like, how does he have this job? He's just awkward all the time.
That's a toughie. I mean, that poor, I don't really know Jim Gray, but
yeah,
that's unfortunate for number one on that. I mean, like, I know him, I don't have an opinion on him, but you have a really good top five list there. Yeah, you hate him.
I didn't have any women on that list.
Yeah, I was actually going to ask you. I was like, do we need to have a woman on there just to be
okay,
fair?
Mary Carrillo. Whenever she would call a tennis game, I couldn't listen to it. It would just be like, she'd be talking so much, and I just like had to turn the station.
Oh, that's tough, yeah. we'll do the top five best ones at some point, all right? I think we know where they are right here on Call It a Net. Okay, awesome insight and food for thought. We're not calling it a night just yet. We're going to bust out the bongos, lay down some tracks of our own. Watch out, Guster. We're starting our own band next. there, kiddies. Welcome on back to Call Tonight on Fubo Sports Network. We couldn't have Brian from Guster on without learning some of the tricks of the trade on playing the drums. Now, Brian, you have a unique musical approach to the drums. You use a lot of, like, your hands. How did you get into just, like, really using your body to play the instrument?
I kind of started in college, just literally brought one pair of bongos to college and put them on my shelf, and then, like, I pretended I knew how to play them, and the guys let me in the band. So from there, we just kind of ran with that instrumentation. I never took a lesson, and I've never given a lesson, so this is a first.
Oh my gosh.
But it just became something that felt real natural to me to just play hand drums in a rock and roll kind of way.
And for anyone who's ever seen you perform, you use so much of your body. I just kept thinking, oh my gosh, you must have to ice your arms or stretch. Like, how do you deal with it physically?
Yeah, it's fine. There was back in the day when I hit really hard and was more abusive, I had to ice my hands after a show. But yeah, like I said, I use sticks more often now, and right. Now I'm in good shape.
Okay, yeah, you got it. As we were saying, like athletes, you kind of adjust over time so that you can keep playing forever,
yeah.
You know, because you also hit the cymbals.
I'm 46 and I'm still going. Barry Sanders only made it till 30.
Yeah. Yikes, right? Yeah, you don't want to retire anytime soon.
What'd that guy ever do?
Yeah, he's a nobody. Okay, so we clearly have bongos here the whole time.
I'm gonna just...
All right, okay, well, we'll see you later.
No, I just, I'm gonna play with my jacket on.
Oh, yeah, okay. Okay, all right.
Oh, I forgot. Oh, shoot. And now Guster will never play in China, and now Fubo will never be on in China. You guys just got, I was an accident. I forgot I was wearing this.
Wow.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Statement action.
I'm sorry.
Keep the jacket off, it's okay.
Okay, but Yao Ming won't like it.
You should have thought of that one before. I guess you put that on the shirt. That's all right.
Sorry.
Okay. We are going all the way. Luckily, we're not ESPN. Okay, let's get into a little bongo demo.
Okay, we'll see if you're good at the bongos.
Okay. I don't think I am.
This is a segment I like to call Call and Response.
Okay, great. Call and Response.
Okay, I'll do something and you repeat.
Okay.
We'll start easy.
I added one more,
but you recognized it, so we get to keep going to
wow.
The next round.
I passed the first grade. Okay. Can you tell us, what are some little like tips and tricks on the bongos? Like, is there areas you can hit part with your hand?
I don't really know.
Oh, okay.
Like I said, I don't. If you hit it right on the edge, it'll kind of project a more high-pitched tone. Hard. You have nails.
Ow. Okay, well, let's get into you playing the bongos. There's a great song that you have a wonderful role in it, Barrel of a Gun, and I'd love if you could play a little bit from it.
Oh, you're going, taking the clock
Take
back
it away.
To 1999. This is the same beat as the Call It A Night theme song.
No, it's not. We did not take that from you.
So do this. Now here comes this part. It's you. Yeah.
Awesome. Okay, and you told us you know all of the Guster songs for years and years and years, but your favorite one is On the Ocean.
I like that song. It came out really good.
Okay.
We don't play it ever live.
Well, you got that opportunity right now.
You want me to jam along? Can we edit this out?
You can, no, you can hold it like this. They're like, what is this show? And what are they doing on it? Okay, but now my favorite song in the entire world happens to just randomly be the song that we have on our show, Call It a Night. So I want to play it, because we don't have that version yet. So let's just hear some of the Call It a Night song, and then we're going to play. Pick up the bongos. Let's play.
Ready? Okay.
Of coming up with the lyrics. We just laid down the tracks. So I'm really excited that you and I are now a new band.
I hope that the Call It a Night theme.
Binks and Brian on the bongos.
Yeah. That this is a night and we are calling it. Was that new when you made that up off
the
top
of your head? Well, we've kind of been singing it in the office. It's, you know, I can't take full credit for those lyrics.
That seems like something that had been worked out ahead of time.
For a while. Let's see. All right, okay, great stuff. We just recorded a song for free. What a scam we're running on this show. We got to take our final time out, but we will be back with more fun after this. Tune in to see the Soccer World Cup on Fubo Sports Network, the excitement of a six-a-side football in a 40-team global tournament. The action continues all weekend long, leading up to the finals this Sunday, right here on Fubo Sports Network. And before we call it a night, Brian, where can we find you next?
We're kind of writing songs in a rehearsal space in Nashville for a while. Come on down.
To our rehearsal space in Nashville. That's a lot of fun, and I'll be going to your Terminal 5 concert because it got rained out last time.
So yes.
That's like makeup show, but like no one else can come because it's sold out. But and then you guys are going back on tour February or?
Yeah,
around?
End of February we're going to start. I guess we're announcing it here on Call It a Night.
Yep. Tour. Guster Tour is back with the Call It a Night single. Thank you, Brian.
This is a night, and we are calling it.
This is a night, and we'll see you guys next week.